Dear friends, in this video I am going to discuss about the information to be submitted to depositories by listed companies. Automation of continual disclosures under Regulation 7, Section 2 of the SEBI, Prohibition of Insider Trading Regulation 2015. System-driven disclosures have to be made to depositories. As per a SEBI circular number SEBI 85 dated May 28, 2018, listed companies were required to provide to the depositories the information including PAN of the directors and the other category. Category and level: 1. Director, then CEO with directorship, CEO without directorship, employees up to 2 levels below CEO. Employees, CEO and up to 2 levels below CEO has to be, information have to be given. In addition to the above category level, the following three categories levels have been added by SEBI. It is now required to give all the information about this in addition to the CEO and director, promoter, promoter group and other designated person. NSDL or any other depository will enable the listed companies to provide information including PAN about its promoters, members of the promoter group, designated persons and directors on issuer portal. This https issuernsdl.com. Companies who are already registered on issuer portal for system driven disclosure or foreign investment limit monitoring film can use their access login credential for providing aforesaid information. So this is about the NSDL. You have to follow the instruction of the other depositories. So what are the information to be provided? It is provided in Excel sheet. I have given the link of the Excel sheet in the description of the section of the video. You can go and access to that Excel sheets. Now the column 1, issuer code, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th character of ISIN. So ISIN, each client ISIN, the 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th column has to be provided. Now, column number 2, name of the promoter, director, designated person. Column number 3, code for category level of promoter, director or designated person. Column number 4, director identification number, DIN. Column number 5, PAN of the promoter, director, designated person. Column number 6, BOID, DPID plus client ID. Column number 7, depository flag for BOID, NRC. Column number 8, add or deleted flag. Column number 9, add or delete effective date, that is year, month and date. How to fill up the column in the format? Column number 1, issuer 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th characters in ISIN. Company needs to mention the issuer code in column number. Issuer code is the 4th and 5th, 6th and 7th characters of the ISIN. For example, for ISIN, INE 123A 0101, of the company, the issuer code is 123A, which is the 4th, 5th and 6th and 7th characters of the ISIN. Column number 2, name of the promoters, director, designated person. Mention the name as per the PAN. Important, as per the PAN, you have to mention the name of the promoter, director or designated person. Column number 3, code for category level of promoter, director or designated person. So you have to enter the code, the following code. For director you have to enter one code, for CEO with the directorship 2, CEO without directorship 3, employee up to 2 levels below CEO 4, promoter 5, promoter group 6 and other designated person 7. Column number 4, director identification number. Director identification number to be provided in the case of directors, CEO with directorship. Column number 5, PAN of the promoter, director and designated person. For a promoter, director or designated person, PAN is to be provided in case of PAN exempt cases, BOID. Details of the DMAT account in NSDL and CDSL should be provided. Foreign national directors or designated person in listed companies and do not have PAN, companies need not provide their details. As and when these foreign national obtain PAN, the company may provide the details of the such directors to the NSDL. Column number 6, BOID, DPID plus client ID. Only in case of PAN exempt case, POID details should be provided. For example, in case of NSDL, it may be the form IN9999123456789, where IN9999 is the DPID and 1234567 8 is the client ID. In case of CDSL, it may be in the form of 1234567 8 1234567 8. Column 7, depository flag for BOID NRC. Only in case of PAN exempt cases, depository flag should be provided in addition to the BOID details as provided in column 6. The depository flag to be selected will depend upon the depository in which DMAT account is opened. Flag N will be for NSDL and C will be for CDSL. Column number 8, add or delete flag. For new records to be added, the company must mention the code A in the column. In the case of company wants to delete any record, code D must be mentioned. Column number 9, add, delete, effective date. Effective date is the date on which the NSDL will initiate monitoring. To start with, the effective date could be date as per SEBI circular dated. The column effective date should be in the text format. For example, 2020-1001, where year is 2020 and month is 10 and date is 1. Company must provide the information about the directors and employees in the prescribed format. The file naming convention will be PIT DTLs for NSDL. Closure code, day, year, month and date, lesser than 3-digit running sequence number, XLS example, PIT deals 123A. You have to save the XLS file after filling the information under as per this instruction. Friends, I think this video will be more informative to you. If you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thank you once again, RV Shekhar, practicing company secretary.